I've spent the better part of my week downloading and testing tons of Google Play applications, and today I come here before you with the 10 best apps for Android phones. Let's make your smartphone faster, safer, smarter, and prettier. Ah, you get the point. Let's go. First, you don't have to be stuck with a single default Android look. If you want to change it, try a launcher. My main recommendation is the Nova launcher. It's lightweight, easy to use, but insanely customizable. It lets you play around with app icons, change colors of basically everything, add animated effects, and a ton of other stuff. The premium subscription unlocks even more perks, but honestly, to me, the free version is more than enough. So I highly recommend checking that out. In my view, Nova is the best Android launcher, period. But if you want a minimal and very quick to set up launcher, Niagara stands as my honorable mention. My next find was a really great app for file sharing, Local Send. It allows sending files and messages between any operating system. So yes, you can easily transfer files from Android to iPhone and laugh at Apple AirDrop. This app is free with zero ads and no hidden costs. Honestly, almost too good to be true. And it would be suspicious, but LocalSend is completely open source, meaning their code is available for anyone to inspect and point out vulnerabilities. On top of that, it's easy to use as the design is very simple and intuitive. I didn't even need to register. Okay, some info needs to be shared, but you might want to keep other stuff under lock and key. I am talking about passwords. And from all the apps I've tested, to me, NordPass proved to be the best password manager for Android. It upholds strong security standards, so all your logins will be kept safe and sound. But the best part is the seamless autofill on mobile. When I need to log into a website or fill in a form, suggested info just appears by itself above my keyboard and I can add it with a single click. Plus, NordPass has a cool set of additional tools from a password generator, a data breach scanner, and even email masking for added privacy. There's a free NordPass version available, but it's very limited, basically to just saving passwords on Android, though you can access them from a different device too. But you'll need to log out and log in every time, which gets very annoying very quickly. But since the premium app is so affordable, I've got that one. Plus, I got an additional discount with a coupon code, which you can use too, by the way. Check the description if you need it, or just scan this QR code. Now, I want to introduce you to the best weather app for Android, WeWow. Isn't WeWow fun to say? I mean, just look at this rating score on Google Play. Need I say any more? Okay, I do, actually. WeWow is neat and easy to use, and most importantly, well, it's accurate. A big reason for that is the fact that you can select a data source. If you're not sure about which one is best for your location, just look up your zip code or city on the Forecast Advisor website. The weather app is free as well, with zero ads in sight. They sustain themselves with donations from users, which unlocks a few more data sources and capabilities. Oh, and I really like how customizable WeWow is. You can choose what data you want to see and can even customize widgets to put on your home screen. All right, moving on. If you want to know how to stop notifications on Android, get an app called Buzzkill. You can do so much with it, from avoiding multiple notifications when somebody keeps texting you, yes, mom, to custom vibrations for specific apps or contacts. I also really like that I can schedule when I want notifications to arrive and even receive them in batches. And the ability to stick important notifications was also really cool, especially if you're like me and you use your notifications as an improv to-do list. Now, yes, this app is paid, but it's once in a lifetime payment and it's less than a cup of coffee. Tasker. Great app for automation, also follows the same strategy. You pay once, you get a great app to automate pretty much everything that your heart desires. People use it to create backup alarms, auto save your car location, get specific notifications based on keywords, auto silence your phone during meetings. The possibilities are basically endless, and your device doesn't even need to be rooted for it to work. However, Tasker is very technical, and I mean very technical. I can recommend this one only to advanced users or extremely adventurous beginners. The good thing is, though, this app has an active subreddit and a very responsive developer. So if something doesn't work, you can always get help. Now, here's a super versatile but easy to use app, Mix Explorer. It's a great file manager, and although it's paid, I don't regret the few bucks I spent on it. Mixplorer has pretty much every feature imaginable for all kinds of file management. You can read PDFs, pack or unpack zip files, customize how you view and sort each folder, encrypt files. The whole feature list is huge. You can even customize the Mixplorer itself. And I'm not just talking about choosing colors. You can enable or disable all the menu options and even action buttons. So yeah, check it out, it's great. A lot of you guys often ask me, what's the best browser for Android? And the other half of you run to answer those in the comments, praising Brave browser. I totally agree. Brave is a privacy-first browser project with no tracking and data collection shenanigans that you get with Chrome. Actually, if we compare Brave to Chrome, the Brave browser is also faster, more lightweight, has lower data usage too, since it has a built-in ad blocker, which, by the way, works on video ads too. But if you're really into privacy, I always recommend pairing your browser with a VPN. While Brave does offer its own VPN, it's not the best VPN for Android by far. Instead, check out something like NordVPN. Yeah, it's very hyped and advertised online, but there's no denying that this VPN delivers on their promises. They have extensive privacy protection measures, but keep top-tier speeds, boasts a huge server fleet, and a number of cool features like an ad blocker that can also catch malware. So check it out. Just a friendly tip, don't buy the subscription through the NordVPN app. It is pricey. Instead, you can get a coupon code through the link in the description and get a much better deal on their website. And now I want to show you an Android battery saver. It's called AccuBattery, and it's free to get from the Play Store. It accurately tracks battery wear, real capacity, and charging habits, all to extend your poor battery's lifespan. It also provides real-time stats on power consumption, charging speed, and temperature. However, I recommend getting this app to check your battery stats and identify problem spots. Deal with that, and then just delete it, because eventually it's just one more app to drain your phone's battery, no matter how lightweight it is. So out of these 10 best apps for Android, which one are you planning to get? Let me know in the comments down below, or tell me about other cool Android apps that you found. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe on your way out, and I will see you, of course, in the next video.